While I'm modeling, especially while working on low poly models for games, sometimes I need more resolution for my mesh, but adding a complete loop tool will add a lot of unnecessary geometry and easily get out of control. I'm gonna use this low poly model I'm currently working on as an example, where I want to add extra geometry to this curve, but I don't need more vertex on other parts of the mesh. The first method I'm gonna explain is using the subdivide command, the most commonly used tool for these cases, but it's not the only way, so later I'll discuss other methods and tips. Basically, if you select any face, edge, or various vertices and use right mouse click and then come to subdivide, this tool will divide by half the selected geometry. On the tool options, I can select how many times I want to subdivide the mesh, and then I just have to normally rearrange the geometry, so the new vertex contribute to enhance the curve. Another tool I've been using a lot lately is Extend Vertex. When selecting a vertex and pressing the hotkey Alt-D, automatically creates a new vertex on the closest edge, that I can instantly move and place anywhere I want. If you press G while moving it, the vertex will slide across the edge. Now that I have this vertex in the middle of the edge, creating some N-gons on the adjacent faces is the perfect situation to show two more ways to add geometry. The first one is using the Bevel Vertex tool with Ctrl-Shift-B. Similar to the usual bevel tool, I use mouse wheel up or down to change the number of vertex I want. It's important that if you just want to add some resolution to an edge like on this situation, the vertex should be isolated in the middle of the edge, not connected to other geometry. If it's connected to more geometry, the vertex bevel will create this kind of shape, that usually is not what we need. Coming back to the previous situation with the adjacent N-gons, it's possible to add single vertices with Ctrl-R hovering the mouse over the edge, instead of adding complete edge loops. One of my favorite methods for how fast it is. And the last option I have to add more geometry on this edge is very basic. Just use the knife tool from the closest vertex to the edges I'm working on. And those were all the ways I could think to add geometry to an edge. Maybe there are some more that I don't use, but anyway, I think 5 different ways to do it is enough to work on any situation you may face. So thanks for watching and have a nice day.